Gracious and most merciful, whose bounties are unbounded. A warm good afternoon to all of you who are present here. I would like to call Hamad Ilyas for the recitation of Holy Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى. سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى صدق الله العظيم.
جزاك الله. The quality profession has empowered organizations to succeed regardless of their sector and across all geographies. Quality has made significant contributions to advancement in healthcare, manufacturing, construction, energy, etc. And we are here celebrating this legacy. The main purpose behind this seminar is to raise the level of quality awareness. For this, I would like to call Dr. Professor Ali Sajid to come on the stage and share his thoughts.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Dr. Kamran Musa, the Global Quality Guru, Engineer Zubair, and our learned guests. It's my pleasure, it's my honor. I will take only 1 or 2 minutes just to welcome the prominent guest today. Every year we celebrate World Quality Day here in the university. And purpose of these kind of gathering is nothing but to give the exposure about the importance of this ignored but very important segment of life, that is quality in service, quality in manufacturing, quality in presentation, quality in education, quality in life, quality in leadership, everywhere. Luckily, few present and ex-vice chancellors of Lahore, they established a quality forum in the recent past, and they are meeting every week to see how we can create or add value to the new Naya Pakistan of great vision of Prime Minister of Pakistan. We are still in the embryonic phase, and we are trying to focus on certain core issues, including artificial intelligence, as a mean to maneuver and play a vital role in the coming arena in Pakistan. Today, we are lucky to have the real quality guru of Pakistan, Dr. Kamran Musa, who started this journey alone 30 years ago. Aur Allah ke fazl se inke hazaron, tens of thousands of students or followers or trained soldiers Pakistan ke har jagah pe. Jab main NUST mein tha aur EME college mein tha, we are the beneficiary of his services, in most cases free of cost. और अब टुडे वी आर लकी कि उस कारवाने मोहब्बत और खुवत में एक और एलिमेंट ऐड हो गए हैं जिनका नाम है इंजीनियर ज़ुबैर. ज़ुबैर साहब की शख्सियत किसी तारुफ की मोहताज नहीं. इज़ अ ग्लोबल गुरु ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बेस्ट एंड द बिगेस्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वी कॉल्ड इट अमेरिकन सोसाइटी फॉर क्वालिटी. उसकी सर्विस क्वालिटी का जो फ्रेमवर्क है, पाकिस्तान को ये नाज है, हमें ये प्राइड है कि ग्लोबल सर्विस क्वालिटी का जो फ्रेमवर्क है इस नौजवान ने 30, 40, 60 जितनी भी एज है इसकी यंग एज में इसने कर दी है, नामुमकिन को मुमकिन. और इनके नीचे पूरे अमेरिकन से पूरी दुनिया के लोग काम कर रहे थे और ये खुद कभी अमेरिका नहीं गए. और हम अमेरिका अमेरिका ख़त्म हो गए हैं, हमने कुछ भी नहीं किया और ये बहुत कुछ कर गए हैं छुप के. हम इनकी दाद देते हैं, इनकी हिम्मत को अप्रिशिएट करते हैं. और वी आर लकी कि हमारे पास 2 से 3 कोर्सेज पढ़ा रहे हैं एज ए फैकल्टी. और आप भी लकी हैं कि आप बेनिफिट ले रहे हैं इनकी विजन से. 15 साल पहले ये केस इस्लामाबाद में आए थे किसी मेरे लेक्चर अटेंड करने, और आज 500 गुना बढ़ गए हैं मेरे से. मुझे खुशी है कि मेरा लगाया बूटा एक बहुत तनावर दरख्त बन के दुनिया को दे रहा है इस वक्त साया, मुझे नहीं कौम को नहीं दुनिया को. और मेरी गुजारिश है ज़ुबैर साहब से, इंजीनियर ज़ुबैर से, कि 500 ज़ुबैर और तैयार करेंगे तो तब बख्शिश होगी, इससे खाली बख्शिश नहीं होगी. द जॉब ऑफ लीडर्स टू क्रिएट मोर लीडर्स. और आप, मुझे उम्मीद है कि 10 से 15-50 ज़ुबैर आप में से पैदा होंगे जो उनको रेप्लिकेट करेंगे, जो उनकी क्वालिटीज़ को, हम्बलनेस को, केयर को, लव को, एंड अबव ऑल एजुकेशन को और बॉडी ऑफ नॉलेज में वैल्यूडेशन को. तो मैं इस तमहीदी कलमात के बाद आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम द ग्रेट क्वालिटी ग्लोबल गुरु दैट इज़ इंजीनियर ज़ुबैर. तालियों में इस्तकबाल करें 30 मिनट्स के लिए इनको. मैं रिक्वेस्ट, बहुत शुक्रिया.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम लेडीज़ एंड जेंटलमैन, ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर अली साजिद एंड डिस्टिंग्विश्ड डॉक्टर कामरान मूसा, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग मी दिस ऑनर टू स्पीक एट दिस ऑगस्ट प्लेटफॉर्म टू स्पीक टू माय स्टूडेंट्स एंड द इंडस्ट्री प्रोफेशनल्स एंड शेयर सम ऑफ द व्यूज एंड वर्क दैट वी हैव कंडक्टेड globally, particularly with American Society for Quality. So, at American Society for Quality, we have a certain format to celebrate the World's Quality Day. So, I'll be going through over my brief introduction because I think this ceremony and this opportunity require me to share some of the glimpses of the quality avenues that I have been working with all over the world. I'll share about few organizations, how do they celebrate the World Quality Month and the Quality Day and the Quality Week. Very quickly, we'll recall and refresh our memories with the contribution of global quality gurus. And this is the right time to pay tribute to those people. I think this is also an opportunity to share some of the emerging areas in the field of quality management in the perspectives of modern technological revolution, particularly Industry 4.0. I have a couple of photographs to share with you. And by the end of this talk, I'll be asking you what is your share or what is your plan for the years to come to contribute to the global quality awareness and uplifting the standards of quality. Last one, I would like to acknowledge the support and the help of a lot of quality gurus and professionals who have helped me to come to this level. And it was really moments of pleasure to listen such remarks and compliments from distinguished Dr. Ali Sajid. Again, I'm thankful, Dr. Sir. Little bit about myself. Dr. Sir has shared that I've been the chair, Service Quality Body of Knowledge I have been working with American Society for Quality now for almost 15 years. And 5 years ago, I was asked by them to assume the position of Chair, Service Quality Body of Knowledge. Now, this position is usually for 1 year term, but I have this unique honor that I've been asked every year to assume this position. Secondly, since 2015, I'm also working as a member on the Technical Communities Council to unify the quality body of knowledge for all the 26 divisions and member units of the American Society for Quality. I would like to share that since 2015, American Society for Quality has been following a transformation journey to reposition itself to take on the digital challenges that are now being faced by the industry at large all over the world. So I'm also working as an author, reviewer, judge, moderator at the World Conference on Quality and Improvement since 2016. Also, I'm contributing with TUM University, German, as a visiting professor for the Lean Six Sigma courses. Also, I have a commitment with some of my friends at TQM College Manchester in the fellowship board. So this is a brief about myself. Now let's talk a bit about World Quality Day. So the United Nations actually they promulgated to celebrate the World Quality Day in 1990, and they designate the second Thursday of every November to be celebrated as World Quality Day. So this year it was the 14th of November. About the rest of the world, the month of November is celebrated as World Quality Month. So organizations in which we have American Society for Quality, European Organization for Quality, Chartered Quality Institute, they promote and they give guidelines to the industries and the organizations on how to celebrate the World Quality Day, which actually is an opportunity to revive the commitment with quality for the workplace as well as the family place. So we exchange the best practices, we celebrate the success, we see what we have learned from the last year initiative, and we pledge our commitments to work even better than the previous years to elevate the quality standards on the workplaces and the family places. So since I have limited time, I'll skip some of the material that I have spoken about briefly. A little bit about American Society for Quality. It is the largest organization today which is working for global quality standards. So although its name is American Society and it was founded in America in 1946 by combining a lot of independent societies, communities and quality circles at that time, but after it was assembled into the current form, it took on the global challenges of supporting the professionals and the standards association to bring other people into the mainstream, provide opportunities to develop the future leaders in order to elevate the quality standards. One of the significant events that happens every year is World Quality Conference, which is being conducted in different cities of the United States, and it is the largest event of the year that ASQ administers. Now on the screen you see the top quality gurus which have been working to promote the quality not only in one place but to the whole global community. So if I could start from the bottom, you see Dr. Edward Deming, the all-time guru of quality, and he was the person who actually brought the Renaissance in Japan. And today, if you see, the Japan's highest quality award has been named in the name of this gentleman, Dr. Deming. On the upper side, in the middle, you see the photograph of Dr. Joseph Juran. Dr. Juran, he traveled all over the world. He used to be an academician. He used to be a bureaucrat and then he dedicated his life to promote quality all over the world. He brought a lot of practices from Japan and he took a lot of quality stuff to Japan. And in this exchange, he was also accredited to publish the quality Bible of all times, Joram's Quality Handbook, whose first edition was published in 1954. And then every year they took on the challenge to incorporate all the emerging quality practices, new models and new standards into that quality Bible. And I had a unique honor of being a contributor to the 7th edition of Joram's Quality Handbook as well. Dr. Joram lived for 108 years and he celebrated 81 anniversaries with his wife. So that was his another lifetime achievement. But when he was asked at the celebration of his 100th birthday that what was the biggest thing he saw ever in his 100 years, and he simply said that the quality revolution in Japan was the biggest ever thing he has seen in 100 years. So there is a great lesson in the way Japan actually took birth from the ashes after the Second World War, 1945. The gentleman on the left side is Philip Crosby, known as Uncle Fun of Quality. This gentleman, he used to work for a company called the Martin Company. And later this company became Lockheed Martin, that we all know actually develops missiles and aircrafts for America and other armed forces around the world. This gentleman, he boasted while he was working at the Martin Company that if he is given a chance to save the cost, he can save 15 to 20% of the total cost by following a framework called cost of quality. And you know, it happens in American culture. They empowered him and he was able to demonstrate his boasting. He wrote a book in 1979 and the title of the book was Quality is Free. 24 years after, he wrote another book and its title was Quality is Still Free. And he advocated that quality is not only free, but it brings back dividends and profits and welfare to the society at large. The gentleman in the right corner, Dr. Feigenbaum, he was the person who promoted the idea of total quality control in North America. Another person was working on the same concept from the Japanese school of thought, Dr. Koro Ishikawa. Both of them advocated that quality is not the job of one person. It has to be done by everyone. It is everyone's responsibility. It is a state of mind. And that state of mind establishes a common objective for everyone on the workplace to uplift the standard of working. I had a unique chance of meeting Dr. Feigenbaum twice in various conferences where I was invited to present my research. I do have those memories on my mind. He was really supporting and he really applauded my work, and I told him that my research that I was going to present was originally based on his research, and by sharing that he was even more happy. So these are few of my pictures with Dr. Feigenbaum. This gentleman that you see in the picture is Dr. Parsuraman, and he is the first person to propose the rotor or servoquel model in 1980s. And you know that this model is now being followed by all the airline industry, hospital industry, and most of the service industries all over the world. And I also had an opportunity to work for him for another journal to review some of the articles and write some of this stuff. Let's not forget the Japanese gurus. Starting from the left, you see Dr. Koro Ishikawa, known as the person who democratized the statistics. And he was the person who said, statistics is not the job of engineers sitting in a back office. So he was the first person to bring the concept of training the technicians and the workshop and the floor staff on learning the ways and techniques of statistics so that they could apply and they could be empowered to improve the quality on floor shops. The person next to Ishikawa is Dr. Noriaki Kano, and he's really popular and famous for coining the concept of voice of customer, VOC. Next to Dr. Kano is Taichi Ono. He used to be the production manager at Toyota Corporation, and he's the one who went to Sekiji Toyota and asked for the empowerment because he wanted to test some new ideas of improving the productivity and quality on floor. And later, all those ideas were assembled into something which is called Toyota Production System. And it is not only being followed in only automobile, it is now actually become a reference in all the manufacturing industries. The person next to Ono is Dr. Genichi Taguchi. And this gentleman brought engineering discipline into quality, and he is known as the father of quality engineering. He applied a lot of mathematics and statistics into the field of quality. And he come up with something which is called Taguchi loss function. And he proved that if an organization deviates from the nominal values of the product or service, the society at large actually suffers the loss. The person next to Taguchi is Dr. Imai Masaki. He was born in 1939, still alive today, still contributing for the state of quality to make it better. Dr. Masaki worked with Dr. Koro Ishikawa, and they proposed the original 7 classic quality tools. This gentleman also proposed something which is called Kaizen, and he wrote a book in 1986, and its title was Kaizen, the Japan Way to Success. And then he shared those practices by which Japan had made progress. He founded a Kaizen Institute in Switzerland, which is now working on so many places, including India. A new book is going to come by Dr. Masaki, and it is really astonishing to see him working in this age of 90s. The last person in the corner is Dr. Shijio Shingo, and he is the person who gave the shape to lean management what it is today. So you name anything, single minute exchange of die, you talk about Pokayoke, you talk about Kanban, you talk about Enden technology. He is the person who brought these concepts, and he worked with Taichi Ono, and he helped Toyota Corporation, and later on he improved the Toyota production system into integrated production system, which it is today and being followed all over the world. So this was about what happened in the past during the 20th century and in the first decade of 21st century. But as you know, the world has changed now. After the technological breakthrough of Industry 4.0, the working models, the way of living of people, which we call lifestyles, they have changed. And the technological disruptions are now impacting everyone living on this planet. Whether he is a part of that technology revolution or not, he is going to be impacted. So it is in fact a time to explore ourselves and to position ourselves where we are going to be placed in the new revolution and in the new emerging business models of the organization, which has already started taking place in the North America, in Europe, in China, even in Southeast Asia, Middle East, even in India. You might be aware that World Economic Forum has opened a new research and development center in India last year in October. If you look at Malaysia, 31st October 2018, Dr. Mahathir has launched the new policy on Industry 4.0 that will actually make Malaysia's economy more efficient. And slowly and gradually, they are moving towards an innovative or innovation-based economy. So, as you know, the industry revolution, it is based upon something called cyber physical systems, CPS. Automation is now a story of past. Now people are talking about autonomous system, starting from self-adaptive system and moving up to totally autonomous system, planned, driven, maintained, evolved by the machines themselves. So people are talking about something called machine learning, deep learning, cloud computing, artificial intelligence, human-machine leadership. So now leadership is not limited to human now. Now since we are going to have places where machines and robots will work together, so we need to have now new code of conduct in place. The quality has to be revised, and that is why a new term has been coined called quality 4.0. And there is a good news. American Society for Quality has just released a report which was commonly developed by German Association of Quality, Boston Consulting Group, and American Society itself. And this was actually shared in a Six Sigma conference last month in Boston. And it actually highlights the readiness of the organizations to revise and uplift to meet the new quality expectations in the new regime. So people are now talking about digital ledger technology, which we know as blockchains. So fintech has taken a new shape. The world crisis, the trust of the people has shifted from traditional banking towards technology companies. Now all over the world, people are looking upon technology companies to give them the solutions for the management of their finance and the transfer of their finance. You can now see, even in Pakistan, people are now using Easy Paisa, Mobi Cash, and such other mechanisms to transfer their money. And this is a worldwide phenomena. The trust of the common man has shifted from the banks towards the technology companies. So things like Alipay, things like PayPal is getting momentum every day. So what is left to the human once the machines work in the factory and once we have something called service robots? You know that the developed world is now preparing a new agreement for discharging social responsibility, and that is known as digital responsibilities. But how much we are ready to get to know these changes, that is the first milestone that we should do. Number two, how we are going to transform our workplaces, our educational institutions, our societies, our families to move to the new model. Are we going to again resist as a status quo? Or we have something in place as a roadmap? We have some policies on the government level, strategies on the corporate sector and the education sector to help the professionals and the common man to take the full benefit of the spectrum of technologies that Industry 4.0 is bringing in. And we are going to have new challenges, which are now related to sustaining the value chain, how the cybersecurity is going to change, how we are going to evolve and move ourselves to get to adopt new technologies, transforming our organizations towards new business models, developing the new skills, because a big skill gap is going to be generated after these technologies would take all over the world. And you have seen that repercussions have been seen in the United States, and they are still fighting to bridge the gap of skills that has actually come up after this industry revolution. So now I'll quickly share about my contribution to the global quality in this year 2019, which is going to end in few days more. So as Dr. Ali Sajid has shared with you, this is the new service quality body of knowledge framework that we were able to evolve with a very large team of subject matter experts from all over the world. They include gurus like Glenn Mazur, even one dean of the State University in America. He was also part of this team, Dr. Stephen Graham Hill, and a lot of other people. So coincidentally, I was leading this effort as chair of the committee. And before that, I prepared a business plan to them. And now they are following up on that plan. Now this body of knowledge actually covers the emerging areas which are the need of R to adopt new standards, to even evolve new standards. So we have actually listed 22 industries that would benefit from this service quality body of knowledge. And now ASQ is again asking me to continue my role as chair service quality body of knowledge. And I just discussed it with Dr. Lee Sajat last week because it is really, I mean, challenging. It requires a lot of effort. It requires, working with Americans and other people in different time zones, getting agreement with so many global gurus. Although ASQ provides a lot of resource for that, but even then, this is a real challenge. So I look forward to have more support from you people on this. And ASQ, once it was completed, they shared with the public and business professionals on LinkedIn. So this is a screenshot from LinkedIn. And this body of knowledge is still available on ASQ Service Quality website and also on the new platform of ASQ, which is called My ASQ, which is actually hosted on Microsoft Azure platform using SharePoint and other resources. For a few days, you can still download it for free, because after a few days, I'm afraid as the new year starts, only members would be able to access. So this would actually be accessible as a member benefit only. I'm happy to share with you. You can see the signature of Dr. Joseph Duran, Dr. Joseph DeFeo. I was a contributor to the 7th edition, so I got this from Duran Institute. So this compliment coming from legends like Dr. Duran is a lifetime asset. I also helped TUM University, Technische University in Munich. They came up with a Lean Six Sigma professional course, which initially was free of cost, and now they are charging for it. So I was requested by Dr. Holly Ott, who is the lead for all this program. She is an American and teaches in different universities, including German, America, and Singapore. She invited me to help her to design this course and even participate as a guest speaker, as well as a community facilitator to answer the questions that different professionals ask and query during their study and course completion. So I'm doing my job over there. They also shared with me, now this is statistics a bit old, like 3 or 4 months old. Till today, 150,000 professionals all over the world have taken benefit and advantage from these courses. So my voice has reached to a large number of people, especially the people who are making their career in the quality profession. So Alhamdulillah. And ASQ just shared it and published on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn to idealize it for other ASQ members to follow the suit. This is the picture of the shield that I received as a combined award from EDX US and TUM University Germany as a recognition of my efforts, which are still continued. A good news. I have two good news. One, ASQ is asking me to now participate in the Quality 4 initiatives. Secondly, TUM University is also requesting me to help them out on some contents to incorporate in their Lean Six Sigma offering in Quality 4.0. So Alhamdulillah, inshallah, we'll do it. So that was about my humble contribution to the global cause for quality. And it is beside some of the contribution to the national level, like with Government Engineering Academy speaking to the chief engineers, superintending engineers, executive engineers, being invited to the universities, being invited by SAMIDA for the industry people and professionals. But this global contribution is a loud message for everyone, because one of the purpose of celebrating Quality Day is to inspire people so that they could get a strong message and they could give it a thought that how they should be the part of this participation or a revolution, or how they can contribute to improve the quality standards in their life, in their educational institutions, in their workplace, and in the society at large. So my message would be to invite you to join American Society for Quality. It has changed a lot. Now, the certifications that American Society for Quality offers, it is, you know, it is the most reputable and accredited certifications all over the world, because they are developed on an ISO standard called ISO 17024. So there is a complete program to keep the body of knowledge intact, to incorporate the modern practices. So I'm also part of many certification programs at ASQ. Secondly, it will provide you an opportunity across now all 26 divisions. Before it was limited to 3 divisions. Now it provides you benefits of reaching the content across all 26 divisions, including software, including education, innovation, aviation and space and defense, government services, so on and so forth. So you could join this journey, participate, and you, as Dr. Lee Sajjad has spoken about this, that even me, without going there, although I'm invited every year on the WCQI with a full sponsorship, but even without going there, I have been able to volunteer and do a lot of leadership roles to elevate the quality level. And now ASQ, actually, they present me as a model to rest of the ASQ members to follow the suit. If I can do it with this humble contribution, with this humble level of lifestyle, why can't you do it? So I invite you to join this journey with me, be part of ASQ, be part of Service Quality Division, and you get all new opportunities. You can develop yourself, you can learn new skills, get to know the new technologies, enhance your career, and it is really a bright chance to make Pakistan famous as a strong country and as innovation economy. So, but don't forget that, and this is really important. The road to the excellence does not start with American Society for Quality. It does not start with Pakistan Institute of Quality Control, or it does not start with the Lahore School of Professional Studies. It has to start with yourself. So the first requirement is to incorporate the quality into your lifestyle. So the first thing that you should have belief is your personal excellence. If you have not been able to enhance the quality standards of your own life, your own family, your own dependents, how you are going to add value to the organization, to the society at large? So the first thing is to incorporate quality and excellence into your personal lives. Then comes the operational excellence. You could think about the functions, sections, divisions and departments that you are working with. Think about building up teams, think about improving communication, think about defining workmanship standard, think about defining quality of working life. And then you can continue on this journey and roadmap and think about organizational excellence until you become an ideal for the world, which is a benchmark. The new year is now around the corner, few days. And this time in December also provides us an opportunity to think about how did we spend the last year and what we have to do in the next years. So just like operational planning and aggregate planning that we do on the workplaces, Do we plan for our lives? Do we plan for our dependents, wives, kids, siblings, neighbors, friends, institutes, workplace? If not, let's start doing it. So while you define the resolution for the new year, do not forget about the quality, the standards, the quality of life, and the quality of working life. So I'll move to the last slide, and this is really important, to acknowledge the effort, support, enthusiasm, push, and motivation of all those people who have made me to talk what I'm talking today. And मुझे इजाज़त अगर वो मीर तकी मीर का शेर याद आ गया डॉक्टर अली सादत साहब की शख्सियत के हवाले से, हम हुए तुम हुए के मीर हुए सब उसी की जुल्फ के असीर हुए। तो डॉक्टर साहब की पर्सनैलिटी इस किस्म की है, कामरान मुस्ता साहब भी इतफाक करेंगे, आप लोगों का भी शायद अभी से शायद इनके साथ इंटरेक्शन स्टार्ट हुआ है, बट अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वेयर एवर ही हैज़ बीन पीपल हैव बीन एडमायरिंग हिम, टॉकिंग पॉजिटिव about him. I have seen this everywhere, and because he always talks positive about everyone, and that is really a God-gifted personality. He's the first one that I acknowledge his support, motivation, and push to bring me into the religion of quality. So Dr. Sir, thank you very much for that. Dr. Benito Flores, aap inko nahi jante, but he is the chair of American Society for Quality. और ये एजुकेशन के प्रोफेशन से वाबस्ता हैं। ही इज़ अ डीन इन मैक्सिको यूनिवर्सिटी एंड ही इज़ अ रियल वॉइस बिहाइंड द चेंज दैट अमेरिकन सोसाइटी फॉर क्वालिटी हैज़ ब्रॉट। और अब अमेरिकन सोसाइटी फॉर क्वालिटी अमेरिका के उस क्राइसिस से बाहर निकल के ग्लोबल वॉइस बन चुकी, तो ये इतना आसान नहीं था अमेरिका जैसी इकॉनमी और अमेरिका जैसे कंट्री के अंदर जहाँ पे इस वक्त नेशनलिज्म बहुत ज़्यादा अपनी पीक पे है। तो बेनिटो फ्लोरेस हैव बीन पब्लिकली गिव अस रिकग्निशन, पर्टिकुलरली टू मी एंड माई टीम, फॉर स्पेशली डिलीवरिंग दिस सर्विस क्वालिटी बॉडी ऑफ नॉलेज। और उसके बाद के भी माइल स्टोन्स हैं जो मैं अभी आपसे शेयर नहीं कर सकता। हम लोग अमेरिकन सोसाइटी में या इवन अपने पर्सनल लाइफ में, प्रोफेशनल लाइफ में काम करते हैं अनटिल इट बिकम्स अ रियलिटी एंड देन वी शेयर विद द पीपल। तो ये भी एक अप्रोच होनी चाहिए मेरे ख्याल में। सिंगापुर, हमने सिंगापुर की बात की, आपको पता सिंगापुर इज़ टेकिंग नाउ फर्स्ट और सेकंड पोजीशन कंटिन्यूसली फॉर द लास्ट फ्यू इयर्स इन वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम्स ग्लोबल कंपेटिटिव इंडेक्स रैंकिंग। वहाँ के एक प्रोफेसर हैं डॉक्टर योफन वर्ड्स, हु इज़ एक्चुअली अ जर्मन प्रोफेसर। इनके साथ भी हमारी पिछले दिनों से काफ़ी ज़्यादा कम्युनिकेशन हो रही है। ही इज़ अ गुरु इन सर्विस मार्केटिंग ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। और सिंगापुर के बहुत सारे मॉडल हैं जो अब क्वालिटी के हवाले से भी पॉपुलर हो रहे हैं। एक इमर्जिंग एरिया है सर्विस रोबोटिक्स, उसके हवाले से हम इनके काफ़ी ज़्यादा कंट्रीब्यूशन को अब कैप्चर कर रहे हैं इन क्वालिटी 4.0। सो ही इज़ द फर्स्ट पर्सन टू गिव सम डायमेंशंस एंड पैरामीटर्स फॉर सर्विस रोबोटिक्स डिजिटल कॉरपोरेट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी। ये एक नई चीज़ होने जा रही है। तो आई एम ऑल्सो थैंकफुल टू हिम। नॉट टू फॉरगेट एलेजेंड्रा वाइस एंटेटिन, ये खातून जो हैं शी ब्रॉट मी टू द टीम ऑफ सर्विस क्वालिटी बॉडी ऑफ नॉलेज प्रोफेशनल्स। आप इनको जानते होंगे रिट्स कार्ल्टन होटल, जो दुनिया में टॉप ऑफ द लाइन होटल है। शी वॉज द फर्स्ट वन टू एस्टेब्लिश सर्विस क्वालिटी सिस्टम इन रिट्स कार्ल्टन होटल, जो 7-star होटल है। यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दैट होटल, हमारे यहाँ नहीं है पाकिस्तान में, बट इट हैज़ लॉट ऑफ ब्रांचेस एंड इट इज़ अ बेंच मार्क इन होटल इंडस्ट्री in terms of service quality. Dr. Joseph DeFeo, I'm grateful to him. He actually congratulates like you people on every achievement, and he supports us, and he also participates in service quality review functions. So wo mention bhi karta hai aur book bhi bheji, aur aage jo Jurans ke plans hain usme bhi we are keeping him on board. Dr. Holly Art, she is a professor at TUM University, Bavarian University, सिंगापुर मैनेजमेंट यूनिवर्सिटी एंड वर्जीनिया कॉमनवेल्थ यूनिवर्सिटी। शी इज़ अमेरिकन लिविंग एंड सेटल्ड इन जर्मन एंड अ वेरी ब्रेव लेडी। चूँकि यूरोप के अंदर अमेरिकन्स का सर्वाइव करना इतना ईजी नहीं है, बट शी हैज़ नाउ सेट अप न्यू लैंडमार्क्स स्पेशली लीन सिक्स सिग्मा एजुकेशन के हवाले से, एंड शी इज़ गोइंग टू गेट लॉट ऑफ रिवार्ड्स एंड रिकग्निशन ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। हमारे दोस्त और पैटर्न Dr. Kamran Musa Saab, always a well-wisher, always motivates and always prioritizes my matters. मैं इनका भी बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ. पाकिस्तान के अंदर अगर आप देखें क्वालिटी के हवाले से, अभी हमारे मोहतरम स्पीकर बात करेंगे, लेकिन पिछले 70 साल में कम से कम मुझे तो ये दो ही चेहरे नज़र आते हैं, एक डॉक्टर अली साजिद का और एक डॉक्टर कामरान मूसा का. तो ये उन लोगों से बहुत बेहतर हैं जो जुल्मत शब की शिकवा करते करते जिन्होंने एफर्ट करने भी छोड़ दिए, और ये वो लोग हैं जो इस तेज़ हवा के अंदर भी टिमटमा रहे हैं, रोशनी दे रहे हैं और लोगों तक क्वालिटी का पैगाम पहुंचा रहे हैं. आप अगर पाकिस्तान से बाहर जाएं तो यू लिसन ओनली अबाउट दीज पीपल. आई वेंट टू ए कॉन्फ्रेंस एंड दे आस्क्ड मी वेयर इज डॉक्टर अली साजिद. मैंने कहा हाउ डू यू नो हिम, कहते ही इज़ द ओनली पर्सन पार्टिसिपेटिंग. फिर कामरान साहब की बात हुई, कहते वेर ही इज़, फिर पूछने लगे कि आपके मुल्क में और कोई बंदा काम नहीं करता क्वालिटी के ऊपर. हमने कहा जी हमने ये इन्हीं के जिम्मे लगा दिया हुआ, अब क्या कहें उनको. डॉक्टर फीजन बाम वॉज वेरी सपोर्टिव एंड गुरु था ये, 94 years old वेन आई मेट हिम. एंड ही एक्चुअली इसके डॉक्टर डोनल्ड से भी मुलाकात हुई जो उनके भाई थे, तो बड़ा इसने मुझे अप्रीशिएट किया. और आप ये देखें पाकिस्तान का इमेज इस तरह से बेहतर हुआ कि मेरी इससे दो कॉन्फ्रेंस में मुलाकात हुई और मैं दोनों में प्रेजेंट करने गया था रिसर्च. तो ये मुझसे पूछने लगे कि यू आर फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान एंड वी मेट लास्ट ईयर आल्सो. मैंने कहा यस एंड इट्स ए प्रिविलेज टू मीट यू अगेन. And he said, I'm really surprising, Pakistan is getting researchers and you people are into this culture. मैंने कहा जी हम एक हमारे उस्ताद हैं, वो उन्होंने इस तरफ लगा दी है, तो बाकी लोग भी कोशिशें कर रहे हैं. एंड यू नो दिस दीज एक्टिविटीज़ हेल्प टू एस्टेब्लिश द ब्रांड ऑफ द कंट्री. तो हम क्लासों में भी जिक्र करते हैं इसका कि डॉक्टर साहब ने कहा जी मज़ीद आप रेप्लिकेट करें, लोग पैदा करें, होंगे इंशाल्लाह. Although के स्केल इतना लार्ज नहीं, आई हैव बीन एबल टू प्रोड्यूस पीपल बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली नॉट इन पाकिस्तान. बट अगेन दैट इज माई कमिटमेंट टू द ग्लोबल कम्युनिटी फॉर क्वालिटी जर्नी. जे पी रसल, अगर आपने इसका नाम सुना हो, अमेरिकन सोसाइटी के सबसे ज़्यादा बुक्स का जो एडिटर रहा है वो रसल रहा है. ये मुझे पब्लिकेशन में लेके आया. मैं एक कॉरपोरेशन में बाहर जॉब कर रहा था एंड दे वर लुकिंग फॉर ए पर्सन हु हैड एक्सपर्टीज इन स्ट्रेटेजिक सोर्सिंग एंड दे वर प्लानिंग टू पब्लिश अ बुक ऑन सप्लाई चेन. एंड दे अप्रोच मी एंड रसल, जो कि ANSI अमेरिकन नेशनल स्टैंडर्ड्स इंस्टीट्यूट का वीटो मेंबर था, वेरी सीनियर पर्सन, ही पास्ड अवे लास्ट ईयर. तो ही कन्विंस्ड मी टू कंट्रीब्यूट एज ए राइटर इन द बुक्स. को मैंने कहा आई एम सो जूनियर, बट ही सेड यू हैव गॉट एक्सपोजर, यू हैव. और मैंने इसको नैरेटिव भी दिया कि इसमें क्या लिखा जा सकता है, तो उसने कहा चूंकि बाप ने किया तो बाप ही जिम्मा उठा ली. डेनिस हॉर्टर, अमेरिका में अगर आप जाएं, ही ट्रेन्ड 35,000 पीपल इन ऑडिटिंग. और डेनिस हॉर्टर ने और जे पी रसल ने ई ऑडिटिंग फंडामेंटल्स को भी डिफाइन किया था, जिसके ऊपर आजकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ऑडिटिंग भी हो रही है और इसके ऊपर भी पूरा एक फ्रेमवर्क बन चुका हुआ. ISO सिस्टम भी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक हो गया हुआ है, अगर आपको इसके बारे में इल्म हो. तो दीज पीपल एक्चुअली पुश्ड मी टू कम इन टू पब्लिकेशन. और उन्होंने मुझे पूरा एक करियर पाथ शेयर किया मेरे साथ ASQ का, कि अगर आप ये करेंगे तो ये होगा. मैंने कहा मुझे नहीं पता वो होगा या नहीं होगा, बिकॉज आई वॉज हैविंग लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स ऑन द बैक ऑफ माई माइंड कि मैं पाकिस्तानी हूँ, ब्लैक स्किन है, इंग्लिश एक्सेंट इज़ नॉट लाइक यूरोपियन एंड अमेरिकन. एंड आई हैव सीन दे डैम केयर अबाउट दिस, एट लीस्ट द प्रोफेशनल्स. बाकी लोगों की बात नहीं मैं कर रहा. मैंने ASQ की हर महीने मुझे मीटिंग्स अटेंड करने पड़ती हैं ओवर वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस. क्यूबॉक की लेदर से मीटिंग्स होती हैं, फिर आजकल जी इसकी ग्लोबल कम्युनिटीज़ काउंसिल की लेदर मीटिंग्स होती हैं. आई हैव नेवर हर्ड देम टॉकिंग अबाउट रिलीजन, कलर ऑफ स्किन, एक्सेंट, कंट्री, कभी भी नहीं इस बारे में बात हुई, विच इज़ रियली एस्टॉनिशिंग. क्योंकि शायद हमारे यहाँ जब भी लोग बैठते हैं तो शायद इसी चीज़ से गुफ्तगू का आगाज़ होता है. नाम क्या है, ज़ात कौन सी है, ज़ुबान कौन सी है, तनख्वाह कौन सी है, रहते कहाँ पे हैं, सच थिंग्स. बट क्वालिटी इज़ नॉट द नेम ऑफ दीज डिस्टिंक्शंस, क्वालिटी इज़ द नेम ऑफ कम्युनिटी बिल्डिंग. एंड आई एम श्योर दैट यू हैव लर्न दिस इन योर क्लासेस एंड आवर रेवरेंट स्पीकर्स आर गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन दिस आफ्टर आई लीव दिस स्टेज. So, my acknowledgements to all these people, and I'm really thankful for tolerating and bearing with me this 30-minute slot. Thank you very much.